Hi friends, Miguel from Figma here with another Figma tip. Today we're going to be making flexible tooltip components in Figma, so let's go. I'm going to begin by drawing out a rectangle, and I'm going to round off its corners by a value of 16. Next, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to choose the polygon tool. I'm going to draw a little triangle here. I'm going to rotate it, and I'm also going to hit Command E or Control E on Windows to expand it. I'm going to bring this down in size till it's about a value that I want. So let's have it about 40 by 24, and I'm going to bring it right up against that shape until it snaps. Next, I'm going to select them both and make a union out of them. I'm going to go over here and round out those corners a little bit so you see we get these nice round corners around those edges. I'm going to select that union object and then come over here and draw out a stroke value. I'm going to put the stroke on the center and have it be about a value of 8. What I'm going to do now is select the Create Component button to make that a component. Let's go ahead and name that Bubble. So this is now our bubble component. I'm going to command click on the nub of the bubble and choose center constraints as well as bottom constraints. I'm going to command click on the rectangle in the bubble as well and choose left and right constraints and top and bottom constraints. This way it's going to scale up and down and left and right, and the nub here is just going to follow the bottom edge. So I'm going to select the bubble object that we have, and we see the bounds are moving all the way down here. I'm going to hold down the command key or control key on Windows to bring it up and snap it to a position right about here. You can confirm that by pressing Shift O and checking in the outline mode, so then this way you know that it's perfectly on the edge where you want it to be. Let's toggle that back with Shift O. Next, let's create a text field. I'm going to call this tooltip, and what we're going to do is make this an auto layout frame. So I'm going to press Shift A, and you'll notice that now you can see the auto layout controls, the padding right on the canvas. So I'm going to hold down the Option key or Alt key on Windows with the Shift key. So Option, Shift, and then click. And what that's going to do is going to allow me to edit all of those values at the same time. So I can set a value padding of about 48. So now you can see here that 48 padding has been applied to each side. So I'm going to move that auto layout frame here to the left. And now we're going to take a copy of this component, so an instance of this component, and paste it here into this frame. You'll see that it's in the auto layout stack. Next, what we want to do is make it absolute position, so it's outside of that stack, and we're going to align left, align top, then we're going to send it to the back. So I'm going to hit Command left bracket. You can also move it back on the layers panel itself. Let's select our text and make that text black. And now we're going to select that bubble instance, and I'm going to resize it to match our auto layout instance. And once again, if you hit Shift O, you should be able to see where they align. So then that way it's snapped exactly where you want it to be. So what we're going to do is select that instance once again and set left and right constraints and top and bottom constraints. What that's going to allow us to do is expand the bubble based off of the text that's inside of it, because it's going to hug the text inside, and the bubble is going to expand to the auto layout frame. So let's go ahead and call this back tooltip. And let's make this a component. So I'm going to come up here, I'm going to create that as a component. Let's move that over here to the right. Now let's create a few component variants. So let's go ahead up here, let's add a variant. When we select the component set, we can define the property. So I'm going to say direction. And then when we select the first one, we could set the first one as being top. We can select the second one as being bottom. And now let's set it up so it correctly matches that. So let's open this up a little bit. Let's move this variant down a bit. We're going to select the bubble instance inside, and we're just going to press Shift V to flip that vertically. And now that's done. So let's create again another variant. So here we go, we have a third one. So this is gonna be the left side one. Let's make sure we name it, let's say left, and we're gonna select the instance inside of it and just rotate it. We're gonna hold down the Option key, scale that down, hold down the Option key, scale that up, and on Windows, it's gonna be holding down the Alt key, and there we go, that looks pretty much done. So let's create the last one. Let's go ahead, add one more variant. Let's select the instance inside. Now all we have to do here is press Shift H to flip it horizontally and make sure that we name it. So let's name this one right. So the last thing we can do is we can make the text a component property. So I can select this text field and it will then target the rest of them. And we can come down here to the content area in the design panel and choose add component property. So let's name this tooltip text and give it a value of tooltip copy. And let's create that property. So now we can drag out one of those instances. We can select it. We can change it from being top to bottom to left to right. And we can add in the copy to represent it. So thank you and happy designing. Thank you very much and hopefully you found this helpful. Please check the comments for the community file and have a great day.